Now, we will discuss about moment of inertia. This is required when a rigid body is in motion, then we may have to calculate its force, that how much force is required to rotate that body. So suppose we have seen the fan is rotating in the ceiling, or say the pulley, a heavy pulley of a train is rolling, or say a football is rolling on the ground, or a heavy mass, a roller is rolling on the ground. So this type of phenomena, that is called the rigid body. This is a rigid body, they are rotating about an axis. So for that purposes, for those purposes, we require some knowledge about, that is called rigid body dynamics. So first we require the concept of force. So now suppose a body, here a body, that is mass, having mass m, and this is moving with acceleration a. So we will say its force, how much force is required. So we say simply that force is equal to ma, mass into acceleration. So this is the force, because the body is moving in a straight line, so here force is equal to ma. So this is very easy calculation for a body which is moving in a linear motion. Now suppose the same body now moving in a circular path, making some radius. Suppose this is the radius. Now the body wants to move in this path, but some force is acting on this. Now how will we calculate that how much force is required, because it is moving in a continuously in a bending path, it is not a straight line path. So we can say momentarily, if we draw a tangent, suppose when the body is here, so we can draw a tangent like this. So suppose at this point its acceleration is a and mass is m. So okay, at this point its force is m into a. So at this point its force is m into a. But when the body will be here, so it will be another m into a. But its direction is continuously changing. So we cannot say the force on this body is ma always. So it is ma, but we know that force is vector, so it is always changing its direction. So how can we express its force? So to express its force, we require something else for in case of a body in rotation or a body in a circular path. So we can say like this, the force is ma, but here there is a parameter, that is radius. So if we say acceleration, so linear acceleration can be converted as, we know that acceleration is equal to r alpha. So we can say, so this is called force, that is force is ma into radius. If we take force into radius, that is remaining constant in case of a body which is actually rolling or rotating. So here we can say yes, that thing is remaining constant, because here the force is ma. So force is ma, force on the particle is ma, but it is changing its direction. Force here, it is ma in this direction. Now when the body will be here, then it will be, this is suppose circular path. So now the force is, acceleration is in this direction, mass is m. So force is equal to ma, but its direction, initially it was in this direction, now its direction is already changed. So now also the force is ma, but we can say about the center, what thing is remaining constant? That is the force into this perpendicular distance. So force into perpendicular distance, from the knowledge of statics, you know that force into perpendicular distance, that is called torque. So force into perpendicular distance can be also said as, that is the moment of the force. So we say moment of the force, but for a rigid body, we will say this moment of inertia. But first we have to understand what is moment of the force. So moment of the force is, this is F, F is equal to ma, and this is the radius. So multiplication of this force into the radius will give you the moment of the force. So the moment of the force can be written as, moment of the force can be written as force at any direction into the radius. So radius, so force is equal to ma into R. So force is equal to ma into R, because force, we have seen this, that force is equal to ma, and it is always maintaining a constant radius R. So ma into R, that we can write. Now for rotational motion we can write this. Now acceleration is equal to, we have seen this, this is equal to R alpha into R, because in rotational motion or in circular motion we have seen A is equal to R alpha. So from A is equal to R alpha, see this, so we can write this, that M into R alpha into R. So we are getting M R square into alpha. Now this quantity M R square, so M R square, this was the quantity for a single mass. So we have considered just a single mass rotating in a circular path. So there was a single mass here which is having a force F, and that force is equal to ma, and this is the radius R. So this force into radius, that is the moment of force, and that is equal to mr square alpha if it is moving with an angular acceleration of alpha. Then we can write this mr square alpha. Now consider, this is a rigid body. So rigid body means, now there are several masses here. Consider, and that's why I have chosen this blackboard, because in blackboard we can draw some 3D figure very easily, and in whiteboard this is a bit difficult. That's why I have chosen this blackboard. Now consider a body like this, which is having a thickness and this is the axis of the body. Now this is a disc, you can imagine this. So this is a disc. Now this disc is rotating about this axis. Now if the disc is rotating about this axis, it will be like this. Okay. So this is the axis, so it is rotating about this axis. Now if we consider there is a mass here, there is a point mass. So this is point mass, so for this we can say this is only very small mass. So we can take this dm. So dm is the mass of this point. So for this dm mass, so we can say if the radius of from this to this is x, so yes, for this mass there will be some moment of force. So there will be some moment of force for this mass. So what will be that moment of force? So from this previous formula, it is m r square alpha. So if the disc is moving with angular, constant angular acceleration, that is alpha, then we can write this, this is equal to, so in this case it will be, moment of force will be dm, for mass this will be dm, and this will be x square into alpha. So now we require the integration of this thing, that's what I have written here. So we want the integration of this thing. So if we integrate this, then you will get the quantity. So that quantity, which will be, actually we can say this is summation of all the mass into the square of the radius. That means we can say this, we will prove this later. So we will get, there we will find like this, there will be a quantity like summation of all the mi ri square into alpha. So we will get a quantity like this, summation of all the masses, means here it is a mass, there another point mass, there another point mass, there another point mass. So all these are, say this is m1, this is m2, this is m3, so there are several masses, and the radius is also changing gradually. So therefore this m1 into this radius, this m2 into another radius, this m3 into another radius, the square of that radius. So this summation of all these things will form a quantity, so that will be called as moment of inertia. So that is written as I. So I is equal to summation of all the mi and ri squared.
Okay, so we will discuss this for a ring, suppose. At first we will start with a ring.